Independence Day is right around the corner. And this year, President Trump is planning to honor America with a very special 4th of July celebration in Washington, D.C., complete with military aircraft flyovers, historic tanks, and one of the biggest fireworks shows in history. But not everyone's excited. Per usual, the mainstream media is trying to rain on the parade. Literally. Check this out.
It's just obscene. It really is. And I just hope it doesn't spoil the whole day.
You'll see that this is really problematic to the D.C. City Council for several reasons.
As a native Washingtonian, I find this to be offensive. I don't need a tank in my front lawn to tell my neighbor I'm a patriot.
So what is the message Donald Trump is trying to send by rolling tanks down Constitution Avenue? Who is that message to? It's certainly not to tyrants, because he likes tyrants. He loves tyrants. It's not to Putin. It's not to Kim Jong-un. It's not to the Saudis. Is it to our friends? Is it to Western democracies, who he doesn't particularly like? Or is it to us? Is it to the resistance in this country? It's always a threat when you roll out your military. But it's to whom is the threat? And I suspect that the threat is to his fellow Americans.
You heard that right. Joy Reid feels threatened by a patriotic celebration. Meanwhile, out of work, backup quarterback Colin Kaepernick is busy calling the Betsy Ross American flag racist because it represents the 13 colonies, and in the 1700s, some colonial citizens owned slaves. According to the Wall Street Journal, the former backup quarterback turned social justice warrior called on Nike to remove a patriotic sneaker featuring the Betsy Ross flag from the shelves. And naturally, Nike was happy to oblige. No word if Colin Kaepernick is still triggered. Joining us now with reaction on American values under assault is Fox News correspondent at large, Geraldo Rivera, and the founder of Skybridge Capital, Anthony Scaramucci. Anthony, good to see you, buddy.
Yeah, it's great to be here with you.
I'll go to you first. So I thought with Kaepernick during his infamous NFL protest, he had specifically made the point that it was not about the flag. But right. Now a flag appears on Nike shoes, and it's about the flag all of a sudden?
So Nike's making a strategic bet. What they want to do is they want to go for the inner city. They want to go for the youth. They want to play the social justice card. So white affluent sneaker buyers, they've decided not to do that. And that's against the Michael Jordan adage. Remember what Michael Jordan said? He said, I don't care. Republicans and Democrats buy sneakers.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
They're making a big mistake, and it would be a better corporate strategy to be more inclusive.
Yeah.
On the military, can I talk 2 seconds about that?
Yeah, of course.
On the military, I was actually against it. I want to be very fair and balanced, because I'm often worried about, you know, what Eisenhower said about the military-industrial complex. And then I talked to several veterans today, and I talked to a lot of people about the Gulf War I parade, and I turned around on it. I view it now as I understand what the president's trying to do. He's trying to celebrate patriotism. He's trying to celebrate the freedom that the military has presented and represented for the United States. So I have to confess, honestly, when I first heard about it, I was less happy about it. But once again, the president has way better instincts than I do about the American people.
He has very good instincts. Always has. Geraldo, I'll go to you on this. Is this the dumbest business move in modern American history by Nike? Are they just trolling all of us? I mean, why make an issue out of this? This was a ground ball. It's the American flag. It's not some partisan symbol. What's going on here?
You know, in terms of the Nike, and I'd love to talk about the parade also.
Sure.
The whole world loves a parade. They only hate it because Donald Trump proposed it. In Nike's case, it just seems that they're just running so scared. They're afraid to offend anybody. They are so politically correct that they would unravel a deal that was well evolved and had really no offense meant to anybody.
Right.
Betsy Ross and my family and I were in Philadelphia recently. You pass her house, the flag of that she sewed in 1776 is there out the window. People just relate to it. You know, it is preposterous to think that you can't honor our, what are you going to take down the Washington Monument next?
Right.
Because he had slaves, Thomas Jefferson and so forth.
Right.
In terms of the parade in Washington, I have to say that, this is a symbol of the partisan, toxic, malignant atmosphere we have in our country. If you see how Republicans feel about the country right now, according to these surveys, as compared to the way Democrats feel about this country now, according to the surveys, it is amazing. People on the left hate our president so much that they are willing to just put a negative spin on anything. How many times have you seen a flyover in an athletic event?
Yeah.
You know, everybody loves them, except and until President Trump is the one proposing it.
Dan. Yeah, you get goosebumps with those flyovers.
And flyovers are great, particularly Super Bowl and
I remember as a Secret Service agent being at the World Series when George W. Bush threw out that first pitch. I mean, there were no Democrats and Republicans. There were only Americans there at that point.
Well, I mean, that's the thing. So you've got the polarity that Geraldo's talking about, and you got a really bad corporate strategy on Nike. They'd be so much smarter trying to bring everybody into the tent at the same time.
You know, I hate to play devil's advocate, but, you know, it's fair at times. Some of the response I've heard from liberals has been, hey, Nike stock is up and their sales are up ever since they brought Kaepernick on board.
No, you didn't ask me as a capital manager.
Yeah, that's where we're going with this.
As a capital manager, when a stock fell off, I looked at it, I said, they're making the right bet. They're going to sell more sneakers if they do this. But here's the problem. You got to be long-term greedy in a society and a culture because the pendulum's going to swing again, Dan. And they'd be way better off trying to be more inclusive than just focusing on the short-termism of that strategy.
And I agree with you. And Geraldo, I agree with Anthony 100%. I think this was a dumb long-term move. I love this country. I bleed red, white, and blue, always have. I think it's a long-term, really silly play. But this constant reflection, Geraldo, by the left on the negatives of America, focusing on our original sin rather than the blood we've left on foreign soil in World War II and World War I, freeing nations, cemeteries we have overseas with our greatest generation left there. I get it. Every country has some form of original sin. Many countries in the world were born out of some violence or aggression. But the United States has done such wonderful things. What is with this constant harping with the left on the negative all the time? How is this a winner for them?
Part of the problem, Dan and Anthony, is that we don't have unifying moments anymore. Look right now what's happening. You have our women's soccer team in the World Cup. They're going to the finals for the third year in a row. Under ordinary circumstances, we would be right on. We'd be watching in the bars and high-fiving and backslapping each other. But because someone asked Megan Rapinoe, the captain or co-captain of the team, whether she would visit the White House if they won the World Cup, she said no because she opposes Trump's policy. So the performance of our national team in the World Cup, something we should all be extolling their virtue and our kids should be watching and wanting to play like they play. Instead, it becomes you like Trump, you don't like Trump, you can visit the White House, you're not going to visit the White House. It is, it's melancholy. It's sad. Objectively speaking, the country is doing great. The economy has expanded for 121 straight months. Minority unemployment is at historic lows. Right. The wealth gap, for the first time in many years, appears to be lessening. You know, there's great opportunity. The president's trade deal. When he walked into the DMZ and crossed the line into North Korea, right, Everybody should have been celebrating. You know, if you want to make peace, as Moshe Dayan said, you don't speak to your friends, you speak with your enemies. The president went into North Korea, the first president ever. Everybody should be celebrating that. But because this hatred of Donald Trump is so intense, he becomes the synonym for the nation. And I think it's very distressing. People should get over themselves. I mean, as a kid, you watch those 4th of July parades, you get a tear in your eye watching the old veterans, the World War I guy, then the World War II guy, and they die off, and then you're watching the Korea War. I mean, it's a wonderful, life-affirming, uniting moment, and here we're making it a bunch of crap.
Geraldo, Anthony, thanks a lot. Really appreciate it.
Happy 4th of July.
Thanks a lot. Yeah, happy Independence Day to you. Thank you.